Good morning, students. Today our topic is Python programming, and this is Python programming part 13. In this lecture, we are going to discuss the concept of data type and check their implementation using Python 3.x. 3.3 is here. So use Python 3.3 to execute all these codes regarding to Python data type, which are described in our last lecture. So let's start. First of all, just go to all programs, and then there are different versions here. Select one of them, then interactive mode is here. This is a slide which is described in our previous lecture, and today our topic is built-in data type. There are different data types such as text type, numeric type, sequence type, which include list, tuple, and range, and mapping type, dictionary, boolean type, bool. So these are the different data types. And what is data type? Data type is actually type of data. So type of data is called the data type. So there are different types of data which we can declare in our program. It may be a string, it may be a float, it may be int, it may be a complex number. And there are sequence types, data types also. These are list, tuple, range, and mapping data type, dictionary, represented by DICT, and boolean data type represented by BOOL. So these are the different data types used in Python programming language. You are aware of some of them, such as int, float, and string, str. And now in this lecture, we are going to discuss all these data types one by one. So first of all, there is a data type str. So to represent a string, we use str. So if we just write str and then pass a string, then we can see that hello world is the answer. You can easily see that hello world is the answer. And if you write int 20, obviously 20 is an integer number, and we pass and we mention it as int. So int, this is actually called explicit type conversion. Whatever be the value we given within parentheses, if we use a particular data type with that value should be converted to that data type, such as hello words will be converted to a string. Obviously hello word is automatically obviously a string. So but when we mention str before this, then we explicitly convert hello word into a string data type. So and another example, int 20. So 20 is an integer type value we declare, and 20.5 here we declare 20.5 as a float type value. And when we execute this program, we can easily get the answer of this question, such as float 20.5 is 20.5 here. This is a float value. And then let us take another example here. Complex number is there. To represent a complex number, we used complex, and then i1j. 1j is a complex number. In Python programming, complex number imaginary part is represented by j. And in mathematics, as we know that imaginary part we write I, and I is equal to under root minus 1. So in Python programming, J represent an imaginary part. Next is a list. List is a collection of different elements here. So to declare it as a list, we use a keyword list and then pass different value, and you can easily see that there is a sign of bracket here, and all these values are passed are a part of this list, apple, banana, and cherry, and they are separated by a comma sign. So what happens actually here, that we declared a list data type. And then tuple. For tuple, tuple is similar to the list, but only the here difference of representation. In detail, we use list and tuple in our next lecture. but for today you only focus about the representation here. Then range is a function, and we pass a value within a range, then it start the value from 0, and we can easily see that it start from 0 to n minus 1. It means if we pass a value 6, then it goes from 0 to n minus 1. It means 6 minus 1, it means 5. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are the value regarding to that range. Next is dictionary. Dictionary is basically a combination of index value and value, and you can easily see that there is a name, and John, name is equal to John, is declared here. So name is the name of the index value, and John is the name of that value corresponding to this index. And in same way, we can say that we can easily see that age is equal to 36. So age is equal to 36 declared here, and age is a index value, and 36 is a number. Then bool is equal to 5, which we will discuss later on. So let's focus on dictionary, and representation of dictionary is DICT. Let us check it. DICT, name John, answer is name John, and separated by a comma sign, so we can see that there are two different values represented with their index values. Next is bool 5, so it basically represent boolean value. So let us check. Bool 5 is a true. Basically all positive numbers are considered to be a true. All numbers considered to be true except 0. Whether it is a positive, negative, it doesn't matter. So it all these values considered to be true, and when we pass a 0, then it is considered as a false value. So let us check it. Bool 5, then we declared as a bool. Let us check another value here. Just write bool and let's change a value of boolean variable. Let us take another value 0. You can easily see that false. And if we take bool, suppose minus 1, then we can easily see that true is there. So for all value it gives true except 0. 100 for it is also true. So we can say that all value except 0 are considered to be true as far as boolean value is concerned, and for 0 it will be considered as a false value. Now I think all these data type are quite clear to all of you. So just go to script mode, and there is a small program here, and in which we can see that there are different integer types of values given here, and we use a type function here. Type function actually return the data type of that value which declared within that program. So if you perform just copy and paste operation from a particular source, then you may that editing may be required. And remember that indentation is a very important part of Python programming. So just try to just give the name of the program, and if this program is already exist, then actually it will replace the previous one. No, it is not existing one. And we can see that class int represent, which represent the basically these are all of the integer type of data or belongs to the class of and belongs to the class of integer type. Next, in similar way we can see that the we can see that floats 1.11, 1.10, 35.59, these are the values, and we can easily see that these are the floating number, float values. And when we pass these values within that program, we can easily see that the type we return from this program are float, or all these three values, because all these three values are floating type values. And again editing is again required. So remember that if you take a program for another source, then editing may be required, and you can easily see that all are the float type of values. So now there are other float value representation here. We can easily see that float value can be represented using sign e for exponential. So e represent here 10 power. So when we write a number such as here is small program here, first of all let us see this program in line number 3rd. We write 87.7 e 100 87.7 into 10 to the power 100. So all these are our float values, and e we write in small letter or capital letter, it doesn't matter, it represents a float value. Yes, you can see it, all values are of float type. So now I hope logic is clear to all of you as far as data types is concerned. So now complex number x is equal to 3 plus 5j, y is equal to 5j, z is equal to minus 5j. We can easily see that these all are the complex number, because complex number there is a character used j which shows the imaginary part. So j represents the imaginary part of that program. And this is a program here. Okay, we'll already execute it. So let us take another concept regarding to the complex number. Complex number have imaginary part. There is a compulsion of imaginary part. If they have no image real part, then we consider it as zero. For example, x is equal to 3 plus 5j, it means there is a real part 3 and imaginary part 5. But in second and third part, real part is absent, and so we consider real part as a zero. So for representation of complex number, imaginary part, there is a compulsion of imaginary part. So or we can easily see that these all are they are imaginary part for all of them. And print different types of print values are there, just execute the program. This we can easily see that class complex is the answer for all the three types of values, because these are the complex numbers. And as if you know a complex number, you can, if you know what is a complex number, always remember that our complex number represented by imaginary part, and imaginary part is I, and I is equal to under root minus 1. But in Python programming, I must be replaced with j, character j. So real part plus imaginary part represent a complex number, and if there is no real part at all, then we consider it as a zero. But for representation of a complex number, imaginary part must be there. You can easily see that y is equal to, this is another program, y is equal to 2.8, z is equal to 1j, x is equal to 1. So int, float and complex type of values are there, and here we convert float value to int, int value to complex, and different types of values are there. And again we check the type of these values a, b, c. So let us check what is the data type, what is the answer we get. After the execution of that program, so just go to Python and go to IDLE, Python IDLE, Integrated Development Language Environment, and go to script mode, new file, and there is a program here. You can easily see that, and just save it and then give the name. If this program is already exist, then it will replace another program. Let us check it. Yes, already exist. So if we click on yes, this program replaced previous one, and this is the output of previous program. Here you can see that print A, print B and print C, these are the values here which corresponding to different values, and again print type statement are there which shows the data type of that value. So let us check what happens when we convert one data type into another, and three different types of values are there: int, float and complex number. So as I told you that there is a explicit type conversion. And what is explicit type conversion? Explicit type conversion means we intentionally declare a data type or convert a data type into another. 10.5, suppose 10.5, as we know, is a float value, but when we declare int 10.5, then 10.5 is automatically converted into an integer type of value. So this is called the explicit type conversion. Now let us check another. Three different types of values are there, so just write type A, print type A, print type B and print type C, and int module. You can easily see that float, int and complex number are there. You can easily see that these are the different values. This is the example of type conversion. Okay. Let us check these all concepts which are explained in previous lecture. We can easily see that conversion into integer type. And there are three different types of values: int, float and string. And what is the representation of string? String always be represented within a single or double quote here. So we declare int explicitly for all of these, and we can easily see that the answer, if we perform a copy paste operation, then it may be possible that due to some formatting, an error will be raised in your Python program. Because in Python programming, there is a very important role of indentation or space. So, and there is also, we can easily see that comment, and comment with represented by hash sign. And they are comment because they are the dead statements. You can easily see that. Okay, no value is printed here because we don't use any print statement here. So successfully executed to print that statement, print all the statement, print, we write print and then name of the variable, print x, print y, print z. So you can easily see that different types of values will be printed. Just click on OK. 1, 2, 3. Yes, all of these three are integer type of values. Now, same procedure. Apply same procedure for float type of value. Here we can easily see that one is integer type value, second is float type value, and third is string type value, and convert all these values into float type values. So replace the program
to the previous program, and obviously there is some editing required because of copy paste operation. And then go to run and click on OK. 1.0, 2.0 and 3.0, all of them are float type values. So, and why this result look like here? Because we declared float. We declare all of them as a float value. And similar procedure, apply similar procedure for string type of value. We can easily see that str is there. So all of the values are converted to a string type value. One is a integer type value, second is float type value, and third is a string type value. String is nothing but the only the set of the character, and the representation of a string is using single or double quotes here. So when we use single or double quotes and write anything between single and double quotes, that is considered to be a string. And we declared here str, so intentionally convert these strings into, you can easily see that these are the three strings but not look like a string here. So let us check whether these are really a string or not. So what we have to do here, just use a type function which return the type of that values. So three statement will be added for that purpose. Just type x, type y, type z, and give the print statement for all of them. We can easily check the different type of data type of x, y, and z here. And as we know that data type of x, y, z is string, but let us check what the computer returns here, or we are correct or not. Type x, type y, and type z. Just go to run, then run module, and then click on OK. You can easily see that OK, str is there. You can easily see that all of them are string data type. Next, you can easily see that a string can be represented using a single quote or double quote here. So hello is the same as hello. Hello first printed within a single quote, and second hello is printed within a double quote. So they are the two different representation of a string here. And there is a multi-line string also within represented within a double quotes, but used three times for closing and for opening. It may be double quote or it may be single quote. Doesn't single quotation mark or double quotation mark doesn't affect on the representation of a string. Both are correct, or both are the two ways to represent a string here. Python data type, so you can easily see that. Hello, what is a string? Now our next concept is regarding to a string, and it is very important, and it is all about indexing of strings. As you know that string is nothing but only the set of characters here, and set of characters, when we say that, it all it includes not only the numbers, not only the digits, not only the characters, but also digits, special symbols, whatever we write within a double quotes, even if we give a five space, and then it is also considered to be a string. So here we write a string hello world, and represented by a variable a. So a is equal to hello world, and within a double quotation mark it is written here. Now there is the position of each and every element within that string, and this position starts from 0. So we count 0 and onwards. So first letter in this string is H. So position of H is 0, E is 1, L is 2, next L is 3, then O is 4, then comma is 5, then space is 6, then W is 7, and up to so on. And if you want to print a particular character of that string, then just write the position within a bracket sign. You can easily see that character of that string, and before this write the name of the string. So just write print a is the name of the string, and within bracket we use index position, and index position is one and declared is as a one. So at position 1 e is there, so e will be printed. Let us check what is the output. You can easily see that e will be the output. Okay, run the program. Yes, E is the output here. And next concept related to this, or the extension of this concept, is slicing, array slicing. Array slicing means a range of a string. So if we want to declare a particular part of a string, then just write that initial position. Before discussing this, let us check different types of positions here. You can here type E, A1. So at position 1, E is there, so E will be printed 5 times here. But when we change the index position 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, then first 4 character will be, first 5 character will be printed, because number will start from 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 is 0, 1, 2, 3, 1. Yes, hello. Hello will be printed. 5 characters are there. Next concept is regarding to the array slicing. As we can see here, that 2 colon 5, it is basically represent a substring of a particular string. 2 colon 5 means character start from position 2 and goes up to n minus 1, and n is here 5, so we go from 2 to 4, because 5 minus 1 is equal to 4 here. So from we start from position 2, then 3 will also be included and 4 will also be included, but 5 2 if we write 2 to 4, then 4 is not included at all. But when we write 2 to 5, then 5 is not included at all, and there is a separation of colon here which show the range, or so the subset substring of that particular string. So let us check here what is the output. 2 to 5, so 2, 3, 4 will be printed, and we can easily see that at position 2 L is there. So what is the output? You can easily guess. At position 2 position 2 is 2 L, and 3 is L, and 4 is O. So double L O will be printed. So next our program is double L O will be printed here. In our next lecture, we will discuss negative indexing. In this lecture, we only discuss the positive string of positive indexing of a string. And in our next lecture, we will discuss negative indexing of a string. So I hope you like this video. Thanks for watching this video.